Hey pups, Arpy here, and I might be a bit late to the party on this news, but before we jump right into that, I want to talk about this art piece here. This was inspired by an MLP version of Blue's Clues, to which I will link in the description below if you want to check that out. And the rough sketch was actually a lot different from this one, but then I realized I couldn't draw the thinking chair from the show. So I went ahead and did something like this. I decided to make my Lucario see Sheldon as Steve, and his family pet Mighty Anna Shadow, Blue. And yeah, Shadow is a female, Blue is a female, so enough said. I debated whether to make Sheldon as Blue and myself as Steve, but I figured since Blue is a girl, I'll make Shadow Blue instead. And drawing actually goes with today's topic. Yes, it's about Blue's Clues. Now, for those who've been living under a rock for the past 20 plus years, Blue's Clues was a preschool game show of sorts that aired in 1996 around September on Nick Jr. Yes, the show and I are about the same age. I feel old. Very old. And it was arguably one of the greatest shows on Nick Jr. and or Nickelodeon. It was definitely one of my favorite shows as a kid, and we watched it on TV or VHS numerous times. And I stayed till the very last clue to watch it. Steve Burns was the Blue's Clues master, until he decided to pursue a career in music. And Donovan Pat was the new host. Don was okay, but no one could replace Steve. No one could ever replace Steve! Now, for me, in my opinion at the very least, there was always something missing with Don that Steve always brought to the table with Blue's Clues. And Blue even got her own spin-off with Blue's Room, which was okay. It was okay for its time, but looking back at it now, it wasn't as great as the original Blue's Clues. Now, I only watched it because of Blue, and Blue alone. And about 14 years later, Blue's Clues had announced a reboot of March of 2018. I really like the show, and I'd be lying if I said I didn't give it a watch every now and again. I mostly watch all the episodes of Steve and Steve alone. I even have some of the VHS tapes, some merch, and I loved Blue's Clues so much. Probably even more than Pokemon. And this was probably way before I started watching Pokemon and Cartoon Network. Well, actually I watched a little bit of Cartoon Network, but still. Hey, I was a weird kid back then. Most parents wouldn't even let their young children watch Cartoon Network or anything else other than Rugrats and Nick Jr. on Nickelodeon. I watched a crap ton of cartoons back in the day. A crap ton. Heck, parents back then wouldn't allow their children to watch Powerpuff Girls because it was too violent. Yeah, my family allowed it because they knew it was a cartoon, they knew I wouldn't mimic it because I was a pretty smart kid. I knew better than to just mimic things I see on TV. Now back to the topic of Blue's Clues. When I heard about the reboot of March, I was both nervous and excited.
You're nerve-excited! It's like you want to jump up and down and yell, yay, me! But you also want to curl up in a teeny tiny ball and hide at the same time! We've all been there!
Thanks, Pinkie Pie. Now that we got that out of the way, my thoughts. Well, seeing that Blue is more 3D is definitely something new. She looks more like a plush doll or felt pop vinyl. I actually want one if they ever make one in real life. I want one so badly now. And when I also heard about the auditions for the new host, about a female host, and rumors about John Cena being a part of Blue's Clues, or being the new host. John Cena, worker with my childhood. That's something I never thought I'd ever say. Now, to John Cena fans, I'm sorry, but I can't really see John Cena working on Blue's Clues or being the host. Though it would be interesting if he does actually become the host of the new Blue's Clues. Let's hope he gets it right. Please get it right, John Cena. Now, they may cast a female host, like a host we never even heard before, or for some reason, Avril Lavigne, Melanie Martinez, maybe. Katy Perry, some random female celebrity. I don't really know. It'd be interesting if Katy Perry, Avril Lavigne, or Melanie Martinez were actually the hosts of Blue's Clues. That'd be one interesting thought there. One thing I do hope for is that it won't get the treatment of Teen Titans Go and the Powerpuff Girls 2016 reboot. Now, 2016 Powerpuff Girls was okay, but it was the new voice actors for the girls that I couldn't stand for the life of me. Nobody can be Tara Strong as Bubbles, or E.G. Daly as Buttercup. They were the OG Powerpuff Girls. Like, nobody could ever replace them. Nobody. Teen Titans Go, however, not too much to say about it either, other than that it sucks and should die in a fire and should have their movie trashed and canceled, so enough said. I do hope the show has better treatment than Teen Titans Go and Powerpuff Girls 2016, but what will Everyone and Everything Else look like? Will they bring back characters like Periwinkle the Cat, Cinnamon, Paprika's little brother, and or Sprinkles, Blue's baby brother? Will they have songs like Mail Time, We Can Do Anything, and the So Long Song Return? Will they maybe redesign the Blue's Clues notebook, like they did with Joe? And if all goes well for the 20 episodes, will there be more? All questions will be answered soon when the show airs this summer. Or this fall. I don't know when the show is actually going to air, because I get confused a whole lot. Anyways, what do you guys think of the idea of a Blue's Clues reboot? Please comment below, and stick around to the end for something very, very special for this episode of Art Speaks.
To play Blue's Clues, we gotta find... a paw print. Right. And that's our first...
clue.
A clue?
A clue!
Then we put it in our...
Notebook.
Those are Blue's Clues, Blue's Clues. We gotta find another paw print. That's the second clue. We put it in our notebook because they're Who's Clues? Blue's Clues. We gotta find the last paw print. That's the third clue. We put it in our notebook because they're Blue's Clues, Blue's Clues. You know what to do. Sit down in a pinky chair and think. Cause when we use our minds, take a step at a time, we can do anything that we wanna do. Now it's time for So Long. But we'll sing just one more song. Thanks for doing your part. You sure are smart. You know, with me and you and my dog Blue, we can do anything that we wanna do. We can do anything that we wanna do. We can do anything that we wanna do.
Hey, you made it to the end of the video, that's great. Since it was a Blue's Clues related video, I figured I'd sing my own little version of the So Long song as a special goodbye to all you puppers. Now it's time for so long. But I'll sing this special song. Like and subscribe and share with friends. Stay awesome strong and beautiful until the very end. I'll see you again. See you later, pups. Bye-bye.